So, Professor Schneider, welcome to the University of Bremen. It's very nice that you're here. You have conducted a study on commitment in crowdworking. And my question is, what makes people committed to their job or to a particular crowdworking platform?
Well, first of all, thank you for having us and having me here. The study is actually a joint project by a group of researchers from Paderborn and Bielefeld. And we have covered a whole range of subjects, including commitment. What we found in the first try to get a grip on this is that there are different routes, different paths to commitment. And first of all, we have to distinguish between effective commitment based on emotions and calculative commitment based on economic calculations. And one of the amazing things is that both types of commitment are best served in one type of platform we studied by giving workers good pay. So they have an incentive system where they've got the feeling that they can ascend, they can be promoted to better jobs, to higher pay, and they are satisfied actually with the level of pay. So emotions, both emotions and the calculated type of commitment are both best served by good pay.
Mm-hmm. And crowd workers are always said that they're more flexible in their time adjustment and how they can work. Did you also find any evidence that they actually benefit from this new flexibility in their work?
Yeah, absolutely. We asked workers about different motives for conducting crowd work, and one of the motives is of course a more flexible arrangement between private life in business life. And actually a large number of people do crowd working as a main employment, and this is of course one of the reasons is that you can be very flexible in terms of bringing private life and business life, professional life together. But actually we've just finished the survey, so there's a group of people who actually look at this topic very closely, but we haven't actually looked at the data yet.
And one final question, why do you think a conference like the Crowd and Working Symposium is important, and would you do it the next time in Paderborn, for example?
Well, we should discuss this. That would be, of course, a good idea, and either in Paderborn or Bielefeld, where the group of researchers is located, that would be a nice idea. And I think conferences are still very important, even though we could communicate via Skype, but in-person discussions are very important. You meet, you can come up with discussions that you can identify joint interests, common projects or papers. And actually, I think crowd working is an area where more papers are in the pipeline than there have been published. So it's very important in this type of topics to meet on conferences, to see what people are working on and to see work in progress.
Professor Schneider, thank you very much.
You're welcome. Thank you.